Cincinnati out.
With that, yeah, I just, you know, he's a lot better. But I think it's really a long shot that he goes Saturday. I think Tuesday is more realistic. But, man, I don't even want to push that. But, yeah, it's a different scenario. You know, when you're looking at your schedule, of course, everybody's asking for North Carolina tickets back in August. You know, little did you know you're not going to have your two key guys. But we'll have to grind without them.
I know. All league games are really, but this starts a stretch where these are like resume, yeah, RPI type of wins, yeah, for Carolina, Louisville, Clemson,
sure,
like for the next five.
Yeah, no, we've got some, I like our math right now. You know, LSU's really working for us right now. You know, they're playing well. That's the great thing about playing in this league. You say the good, you know, well, the bad news is you're in the ACC because it's so competitive and hard. The good news is you're in the ACC because you have shots at resume wins, and you don't have to get them all. Just get the right number of them, and you can be in there. But, it's a quick turnaround again with Louisville. And, you know, our biggest thing is day after games. We can't do much physically. We've got to kind of get some rest and recover a little bit because those eight guys are all long in minutes.
I know you talked about defensive rebounding after surgery. How do you generate more points?
Yeah, I don't know, Tom. You know, we had open looks in both of the last two games in the first half where we really struggled offensively. We're going to have to make some of those to win. I mean, we were fortunate enough to somehow figure it out and play good enough defense on Saturday. But last night, you're scoring in the 50s. You're either going to be in a close game or you're going to get blown out. You know, and I'd love now. Last time we played here, without pretty much both of them for most of the game, we were better offensively. We were in a pretty good offensive rhythm here. So hopefully we can get to scoring a little better here back at home.
With Matt, are you prepared to just let him rest as long as you think he needs to rather than trying to get him back at a certain time?
Yeah, I think it's a two-way street where you listen to him and you know, you certainly listen to your trainer and your doctor. You know, Matt's thing is I'm ready, I want to go. And I think I'll have to temper that because there is a big picture here, and we're not in a bad position right now. You know, if we were 1-3 in the league, maybe it'd be a different story. But I look at it as, you know, God, if we could get him back next week, it would be great. I love the fact that we play on the 20th, and then we have our bye week. And I think that week's going to be really important for him to rehab and get into a rhythm again. And hopefully by the 27th, he's close to 100%.
You think Rex is on the way back up? Or
yeah, I haven't seen him yet today. I mean, he was not. You know, he's got an ear thing, and he threw up at halftime, and we were hanging on with, you know. I told him, I said, stay in bed till Saturday at 6. You don't need to practice. I think he'll be fine by Saturday.